click the subscribe button and the notification bell, so you'll be notified every time I made a new video. So today it's a quick tips on what to bring, what documents you need to bring to the hospital or lying in. So all the documents that I need is here. So since I had all my laboratories when I got pregnant, I put all the stuff in here. So first, what are the documents we need to bring? Okay. First, we're gonna put all our ultrasound in here, from the first ultrasound to the latest ultrasound. So this is all my ultrasound. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 all in all. So my latest ultrasound was on Monday, and this is the accurate one, and we need to put it in the envelope. Next, documents that we need to bring in the hospital or in our lying in is the marriage certificate. I brought the photocopy and the original one. So if you are married, see to it that you bring the original and photocopy of your marriage certificate, because when your husband or the hospital will process the birth certificate of the baby, they gonna need this. So number three is, of course, you're not gonna forget the baby book or your maternity book. So all the checkup and the doctor's recommendation is here, so you need to bring this. That's the number three. And then number four is your laboratory. So since the day one got pregnant, this is all my laboratory. So it's all written here. The result is here. So latest result was my urine. I had my urine test like every month or every other month, because I don't want to have UTI. So the last time I had the, like, my bacteria is high, so the doctor gave me the antibiotic. So that's number four. And then number five is your PhilHealth receipt. So when was the last time you paid, and until you're gonna give birth. So this is my latest PhilHealth receipt. And then of course, I don't really know if we need the MDR from PhilHealth, but you bring this in your ID. So I have my ID with me in the bag. So that's all we need. And also, before you give birth, the doctor will give you the prescription or note reference for swab test or rapid test. So I just had my rapid test this morning, because I'm already 4C, and yesterday, any moment I'm gonna give birth. So the rapid test or the swab test is only good for validity is 5 days. After that, if you did not give birth yet, you are going to. So guys, if you have other question about the documents that you need to bring to the hospital or the lying in, just message me down below and I'm gonna answer you. So so yeah, that's all the documents that you need to bring. And also, besides the documents, you also need to bring money to pay the bills. So that's all guys, and thank you again for watching my tutorial or my tips for documents you need to bring when you give birth to the hospital or the lying in. So see you again in my next video. Bye.